Misophonia is a condition in which strong negative emotions are triggered by certain specific sounds. We designed a questionnaire. 93% of respondents said, yeah, we find the eating sounds as kind of like a trigger sound. The age of onset, the mean age was 12 years. So in the current fMRI study, we use three sets of sounds. We use the trigger sounds, which are breathing, eating, and chewing sounds. And then we have a second set of sounds, which are normally annoying sounds. For example, sound of somebody screaming, sound of a baby cry. These are normally annoying sounds. And then we have the third set of sound, the neutral sounds, like the sound of a rain, for example. We measure the brain activity of people who had misophonia in an MRI scanner while they were listening to these three sets of sounds. And then we compared their brain activity to people who don't have misophonia while they were also listening to the same sets of sound. And the results were very clear when we compared the activity. We found that the trigger sounds evoked a much larger response in a part of the brain called anterior insula. We then analyzed the connectivity of this structure called anterior insula, how it was connected to the other parts of the brain. And we found that this structure was very differently connected to other structures in the frontal cortex, for example, and also structures like amygdala and hippocampus. Now, all of these structures are known to be involved in emotion processing, emotion regulation, and also recall of your past experiences. So we think that this hyperconnectivity, this difference in connectivity that we observe in people with misophonia and when they're listening to the trigger sound, this connectivity pattern is responsible for the overdrive that we observe in the anterior insula. My hope is that, for example, if I'm able to identify the signature, the brain signature of the trigger sounds, then those signatures can be used, for example, for treatment, something like for neurofeedback, for example, where people can regulate their reaction by looking at, you know, what kind of brain activity is being produced. They can self-regulate that activity. Yeah.